Now, Italy has become the epicenter of the coronavirus pandemic in Europe. The first two cases were reported at the end of January, and they involved a Chinese couple who were visiting from Wuhan. The government immediately declared a six-month state of emergency and banned all direct flights to and from China. More than 2 weeks later, on February the 18th, the first Italian national went to hospital in the Lombardy region. 36 hours later, the provincial government said that he'd tested positive for the virus, but by then, he'd infected five health workers, one patient, and his pregnant wife, among others. Days later, the Italian government imposed restrictions in parts of the Lombardy and Veneto regions. 50,000 people were cut off. In the same week, 900 people were detected with the virus. 21 people died. On March 8th, Lombardy, the business heartland of Italy, was placed under quarantine. 2 days later, on March 10th, the whole of Italy, that's 60 million people, came under an unprecedented nationwide lockdown to try to slow what had become Europe's worst coronavirus outbreak. But it seems that it was too late. On Thursday, Italy surpassed China with the highest number of deaths in the world. Dr. Mary Louise McClaws is a professor of epidemiology at the University of New South Wales and says that stricter social distancing measures are required to slow down the spread of the virus.